Right, well, we're here at base camp, and last night the cases from Hewlett-Packard containing the laptop and tape drives arrived in reasonably good weather. Now it's the following morning, and overnight it snowed about a foot of snow. I mean, it really is quite amazing how much snow has fallen. It's about -5, but the cases are here. Let's go and have a look. Here they are. All the way from Bristol. This is where the extreme backup testing really begins. Well, we've just performed the Hewlett-Packard backup, and it all seemed to go more or less to plan. We've now got the tapes to take up the mountain, and Hewlett-Packard can evaluate the data and the results when the boxes get back to England. So I'm quite pleased overall. We had enough power from the solar panels, and the instructions were very good. Thank you, John. I'm completely and utterly knackered. And if anyone ever, if I ever say to anyone, let's try it again, just put me right and say we're going on a beach holiday or something. If I had the chance to come back and I had the money and the time, then I would like to come back. But at the moment I don't have any time, I don't have any money, so it's not looking very hopeful.
Two years ago I swore that I'd never go back to Everest, and here I am with Ben 2 years later. Here we are back in Kathmandu, preparing for another attempt on Everest, except this time it's from the south side in Nepal.
I wasn't originally going to come, and it was only really sort of watching Tom go through all the preparations and looking back at photos of other trips that got me thinking that if I didn't join him, I would always regret it. I really would. It started snowing last night, and all night long I heard the snow sort of sliding off the fly sheet, and it's now almost 1 o'clock and it's still snowing. We don't know when it's going to stop. The snow has been coming down for probably 12 hours, maybe a bit more. It doesn't show any sign of letting up, so we're hoping this snow is either going to slide off before we get up there, or that it consolidates so that it's a bit safer. But really, it's pretty miserable conditions. We're confined indoors, really. There's not much we can do outside.
The snow isn't really bothering me at the moment. We're all quite comfortable here at base camp. At least we're not at camp 1 or 2, like some teams are. We've got everything here. We've got books and, you know, to read and things to do. So, no, it's not getting me down yet. I mean, we've only been at base camp for 5 days or so, so it's got a little while yet. I think patience is the name of the game.
Tomorrow we go up to the South Col. We spend a few hours there and we set off around 9 in the evening.
It is very exciting, I have to say. I mean, last night at Camp 2 I was lying in my tent with Ben, and I was just running through everything in my mind. When you get onto the hill, you realise it's just a serious, hard graft.
You know, when the alarm clock goes off in the morning, you think, what the hell are we doing here? So tomorrow, going up to the South Col, we'll be going through the Yellow Band, Geneva Spur, all these famous landmarks we've only read about.
Just arrived on the South Col, and since I've been here about half an hour, Ben arrived 15 minutes after me. The weather's just closed in. We're just waiting for the Sherps to bring a tent. I think they're bringing two tents, big tents. And then when they do, we can crawl inside and get a brew on.
Just got the stove on, eating some Pringles, trying to just rest and relax really before we head up tonight for the summit. It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon at the moment and we're aiming to leave at 9 p.m.
Okay, we've got 50 minutes until we set off from the South Col to try and climb up to the summit. The wind's died a bit, which is good. It's very, very crowded in here. And water doesn't boil very quickly. So we've been... The stove's been on for 5 hours, but we've only really managed to make sort of 3 or 4 saucepans. Okay, about 8 o'clock on the 18th of May on the summit of Everest, and it's very special to be here, about 6 people here, including Fidel. Views are amazing, and you can just see for miles and miles. It's a very special moment, something Ben and I have dreamt of for about 6 years. And we're finally here, but we've got to get down safely. So I better stop talking.